Okay, so let's start the session. Today will be, I'm going to take 2 hours today, this hour and then fifth hour. Okay, 2 hours. In this hour, I will be closing off the threads and then I'm going to start discussing about unit four. And unit four, I'm not going to start in the next hour also. I will be giving you an introduction, but one important thing that I would like to discuss today's session, object class I'm going to discuss in today's session. 1 minute.
Sir,
yes.
Pole sir. Pole conduct చేస్తాను.
Pole next class లో పెడతాను రా. ఇది unexpected గా క్లాస్ అన్నది వచ్చింది. I think. Fine. Let's start the session, students.
Sir.
Yeah, go ahead.
Main thread కి synchronizing చేయాలంటే ఎలా చేస్తారు సార్?
Try to put synchronized keyword before main.
అంటే దానికి run function రాయంగా సార్ main thread కి.
మీరు తీసుకున్నారా synchronized keyword వాడి చూసారా main thread కి ముందు?
లేదు సార్.
Okay, మనం చూద్దాం ఇప్పుడు. I had also not done it. Let's see how JVM will behave if you take synchronized. I think whether we'll be taking, is it possible to take synchronized keyword or not, that we need to look first of all. Because synchronized is also one of the access modifier. Already for main method, we are taking one access modifier, right? Srikar, are you getting my point? Yes, what I mean to say? Right. So let's take whether it is possible to take synchronized keyword for main method or not. And if possible, and how this main is going to behave, that will be seen now itself. Just wait. I will enter into the program. Any one simple program will take, and we'll see that. Very good questions you are asking. Students, you all of you think like this. I'm not saying that Srikar is great, but he is thinking, right? Don't mind Srikar. Everyone has a thinking capability. The only thing is you, what you are thinking, if you are not thinking, that's the main thing. So if you are thinking, definitely you will be getting the doubts. Here, Srikar, I'm going to take synchronized, right?
Yes, sir.
Right. So this is another thing. I'm going to compile this thread priority.java. Java C thread priority.java. Whether it allows or not, that will check. Yeah, it's allowing. It's allowing, Srikar. But one thing, Srikar, what happened over there is no other thread will enter into the main method, right? Because JVM is going to start main method. And main will be considered as one thread for JVM. And inside that, we'll be starting one more thread. But no other thread is entering into the main method. And you're talking about run and all. That run and all will be for user-defined threads. That means user wants to do a different flow of execution in our program. Then given in such a way that start method playing an important role over there. Start method is playing an important role over there. And with the help of that start method, the start method is taking responsibility to create thread, to create a thread. But here JVM is taking responsibility to call what a main thread. To call what a main thread. Okay. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Right, we can take it here, but with taking here also, there won't be any thing, because no one will enter into the main thread. There will be only one flow inside this main thread. No other flow will come to the main. But if you consider this run method, in this run method, there might be possibility to have two different flows. So before this run method, if you take synchronized also, there won't be any. If you take synchronized, then if one thread is entering into this run method and doesn't allow another thread to enter into it. Understood?
Yes, sir.
One minute, I'm checking other thing, just 1 minute. Okay. Any other doubts, students, regarding synchronization and all? Respond, a quick response I need.
No, sir.
Okay, fine. Let's go with the session. try to observe it carefully. What are all things that are there? What are all things that we need to discuss in what this? I will be asking you randomly. I will be calling one number. Find out five.
Yes, sir.
Have you completed this difference between thread-based multitasking, process-based multitasking? I discussed or not?
Yes, sir.
Hmm?
Multi-threading completed, sir.
I'm asking about this difference between thread-based and multitasking, process-based multitasking. This was completed or not?
I think no, sir.
No.
And I have absented, sir. Absent.
If you are absent, then why you are not watching videos?
I have to.
Why not six? Srivarsha? Why not six? Why not eight? Why not eight? Why 12?
Yes, sir.
Yes, have sir.
It? Who is that? Why not eight?
Yes, why sir.
Right. Have you completed this thread-based multitasking and process-based multitasking? Quick response. Discuss chesama leda. Five 12.
No, sir.
We are not discussed.
Differences, sir.
Differences, but topic wise we discussed, right?
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Have we discussed this thread-based and process-based multitasking?
Topic-wise, yes, sir. Differences.
Yeah, topic-wise, in the differences, in the rendu same, gada, almost. Okay. The next thing is thread model, Java thread model. Have we discussed Java thread model? Java thread model discuss yes, huh?
Yes, sir.
Enti Java thread model ante?
Yes, sir.
What do you mean by Java thread model? Have you discussed Java thread model or not? 539. Have you discussed Java thread model?
No, sir.
No. Have you discussed Java thread life cycle? Thread life cycle gurin cheppana?
Yes, sir.
Eppudu cheppan thread life cycle? Thread life cycle eppudu cheppanamma? Five forty-nine. Have you discussed thread Java thread model?
No, sir.
No. Java thread life cycle. Have you discussed thread life cycle? Say yes or no. You don't know. Why? What's the problem? Why you don't know? So you came for last class, right? Yesterday I taken how many classes? Do you remember?
Three.
Then what are all topics I discussed in yesterday's class?
Thread synchronization.
Hmm.
Synchronized.
Hmm.
Explain the thread life cycle.
Then you said no. Hmm? 26. 26.
Yes, sir.
Creating threads completed or not?
Yes, sir.
So how many ways we are done? Creating thread means how many ways? How many concepts we discussed under that?
Two ways.
What are the two ways? You came for last class, right?
Runnable.
Sushma.
Yes, sir.
How many ways the thread can be created and how many topics we discussed?
Two ways, sir.
What are the two ways?
Extend thread method and
thread method.
Thread, sir.
Thread, what do you mean by thread? Extend thread means what? What we are extending? Thread means what? Twenty-nine.
32. Yes, sir.
What are all topics that we discussed under creating threads?
Creating threads two.
What are they?
Two ways, sir. By implementing thread class, by implementing runnable interface. By extending thread class.
Can you differentiate them?
Yes, sir.
Apart from these two things, any other things we discussed?
Yes, sir.
What are those things?
Single tasking using the thread.
Next.
Multitasking using the threads.
You are seeing on YouTube and you are saying or what your written notes?
Notes written. Thread synchronization.
Okay. See, I'm completely unsatisfied with your answers, students. A few students are not in a position to say what topics we discussed, what topics are left out also, you are not able to remember. So Java thread model, you can easily guess thread model. It's nothing but thread model is nothing but Java thread lifecycle. That's it. And we discussed the topic of thread-based multitasking and process-based multitasking. Differences, what the differences will be there in that? There only one task can be done. Here multiple tasks can be done. There no algorithms can be used. Here many algorithms can be used, especially round-robin algorithms are going to be used. And here, one by one process will be executed. There, what multiple processes will be executed at a time in such a way that the CPU time will be given for each and every process. And then it switches to another process. Again, it switches back to the same process. If two processes are there in a process control block. Java thread model is nothing but Java thread lifecycle. Creating threads, I discussed many things. Implementing runnable interface, extending thread class. And next, single tasking, multitasking, multiple threads acting on single object. Those things we discussed in creating threads and we faced an issue and not resolve that issue. We are going with synchronization topic. And after that, we discussed about inter-thread communication. What is the difference between how two threads are going to be communicated with each other? See, I went in some rhythm by what projecting what is threads and what's the problem in that, how overcoming those threads concept and how two threads are going to be communicated with each other. From beginning of the time, I'm saying that these things are very, very important. But you are shown the same negligency, what negligency that you are shown for earlier topics. This is not an acceptable one, students. This is not at all acceptable. So what you can do is today, I will be sharing you one Google form, and whatever the notes that you have written, scan it and upload into that Google form. Right, whatever you written, scan it and upload into that Google form. Only running notes, that's it. And if you are not written anything, just give your number, that's it. If you are written, then whatever you written, a complete unit 3, whatever the notes that you are written or whatever the pages that you are done, scan it and upload it, that's it. Running notes I'm asking. Okay, I'm not asking you to write. Is it clear for everyone what I said?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So scan it and upload it. Everyone should upload it. If you are not uploading by today, there is no examination also today in the evening, right? So if you are not going to be uploaded, then I will consider that you are not written. That's it. I will consider that you are not written running notes. I given a lot of time for you to write the programs, a lot of time for you to write the theories and all. Still, if you're not written, it means then I will consider that you're not following my lectures. You're not writing the running notes. And based on that, I will decide how to discuss your unit 4 and unit 5. Okay. Is it clear for everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I was completely disappointed with you students because I came to know from few students that you A section students will listen to the class. Even though they're not giving response, they will listen to the class. But same thing, you have done. See, everything we covered over here, only two things are left out. One is thread priorities. Only this topic was left out. Okay. So let's go with any one student. Danish, 41, is there?
Yes, sir.
So can you say what are all topics we discussed till now in threading? Can list out?
Creating a thread, multi-threading, synchronization of threads, inter-thread communication.
Okay. One more topic.
Thread life cycles.
Yes. So, ఎవరైతే వింటున్నారో వాళ్ళే ప్రాపర్ గా రెస్పాండ్ అయ్యారు. ఇప్పుడు ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ రంజిత్ ఐ థింక్ రంజిత్ యు ఓన్లీ సెడ్ దట్ సింగిల్ నాట్ రంజిత్ ఆదిత్య హి ఓన్లీ సెడ్ దట్ వాట్ creating thread, single tasking, multitasking, right? So those are listening and they are responding. They are responding, but those are not listening. They are not giving proper answer. So this is for the students who are not at all listening to my class. The same thing happens in tomorrow or next session also. Randomly, I will call the number and I will ask you to turn on the video also. Be careful. Why I'm doing such kind of things means I already said in the beginning of unit 3 itself, it's very, very difficult to understand. If you're not listening to the classes, it's very difficult to understand. That's the reason I went very slow in multi-threading. And I came to know that there is no use. Even though I'm going for very slow also, there is no use. Only 50%, I think, 50% of the students are listening. Remaining 50, I don't know. Yesterday, I seen, I'm not interested to relieve those numbers. If I say that numbers, then my students might be taking in some other thing. Those students are not at all leaving from the session. I called many times, 5 to 10 times I called them, but they're not leave the session. From that itself, I can understand to what extent you are showing interest. This is not fair, students. This is not at all fair. Try to listen the classes. Try to listen the classes. If you are listening to the classes, then 60-70% of your preparation is going to be completed within the class itself. You're not thinking in that direction. I do understand that sitting from morning to evening and listening to this classes, it's very difficult through online, but offline mode also, it's very difficult to listen. I do understand that, but at least try to give some priority for the subjects, which is very important for you. Like Java programming, operating system, DBMS, right? For these subjects, at least try to concentrate. This will be very useful, especially Java programming, DBMS, those subjects are very useful. Now you came to know how interlink was there between OS and Java. Multi-threading, ఏ ముందు మన కాన్సెప్ట్స్ అంతా చెప్పండి, ఏం కాన్సెప్ట్స్ ఉన్నాయి మల్టీథ్రెడింగ్ మొత్తం మొత్తం మనకి మల్టీథ్రెడింగ్ అన్న డెఫినేషన్ స్టార్ట్ అయినప్పటి నుంచి ఇంటర్ థ్రెడ్ కమ్యూనికేషన్ వరకు ఏ టాపిక్స్ ఉన్నాయి అన్ని చెప్పండి.
OS టాపిక్స్
మాక్సిమం OS, అక్కడ థియరీ చూసుకున్నారు, థియరీ టాపిక్స్ చదువుకున్నారు, ఇక్కడ ప్రోగ్రామ్ చూసుకున్నారు, మీరు ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ చేస్తున్నారు. See, this is not at all fair, students. I said many times, but you are doing the same thing. I don't like this. I'm not saying it for all you students, right? So let's go with an overview of your exception handling today, and then we'll be entering into the fourth unit. And I already given overview of exception handling. Now we'll be going with the overview of multi-threading. See. Right. So multi-threading means thread is nothing but separate flow of execution of separate flow of execution. Thread is nothing but separate flow of execution. A thread represents separate path of execution of group of statements. In one program, there might be different flows will be there. There might be different flows will be there, that each and every flow can be considered as what? Thread. Right. So this thread can be represented, or thread execution can be done in two ways. One is single tasking, other one is multitasking. In general, we need to know what do you mean by single tasking, what do you mean by multitasking. Suppose there is a processor, and this processor is going to provide a services to what? Some set of process. Here, process is nothing but the software. So I'm going to open 2 to 3 softwares. One is Zoom application, one is MS Office PPT, and other one is Command Prompt. I opened over there. I can see what our processors are there, and all these processors are there. One is Chrome, one is PPT, one is Zoom app, other one is Notepad, other one is Command Prompt. Like that, different processors are there. Now what happens is this CPU, what it will be doing is, it will be providing services to one process. First P1 came in, so it provides complete service to P1. After P1 was terminated, then only it goes with next process P2. అంటే ఇఫ్ ఐ ఓపెన్ జూమ్ యాప్, నేను జూమ్ యాప్ ఓపెన్ చేశాను అనుకోండి, జూమ్ యాప్ ని క్లోజ్ చేసిన తర్వాతనే నేను పీపీటీని ఓపెన్ చేయడానికి పాసిబిలిటీ ఉంటుంది. అట్లా అంతే తప్ప రెండు ఒకసారి రన్ చేయడానికి పాసిబిలిటీ ఉండదు. ఎందులో? సింగిల్ టాస్కింగ్, రైట్? ఇన్ సింగిల్ టాస్కింగ్ ఓన్లీ వన్ టాస్క్ ఈస్ గివెన్ అట్ ఎ టైమ్ టు ద ప్రాసెసర్. ప్రాసెస్ ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు ప్రొవైడ్ సర్వీసెస్ ఓన్లీ టు వన్ ప్రాసెస్. ఇన్ సింగిల్ టాస్కింగ్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాసెసర్ టైమ్ ఇస్ వేస్టెడ్ అండ్ ప్రాసెసర్ హాస్ టు సిట్ ఐడిల్ వితౌట్ ఎనీ జాబ్ ఫర్ ఎ లాంగ్ పీరియడ్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్. Right. Next, after the completion of this P2, then only it goes with P3. After completion of P3, then it goes with P4. After that, P4 goes to P5. After P5, it goes to P6. After P6, it goes to what? P7. Like that, the single tasking is going to be done. Coming to this multitasking, what happens in multitasking is multiple softwares or multiple processes can be run at a time. That is what multitasking, right? So to use a process time in an optimum way, we can give several jobs at a time. This is called multitasking. The main advantage of multitasking is to use the processor time in an optimum way. So the first thing is, you can write the differences. The first difference is single tasking. In single tasking, only one process will be executed at a time. In multitasking, several processes will be executed at a time. In single processing, a lot of time will be wasted. CPU is not we are not utilizing CPU time. CPU is to sit for ideal for long period of time. Whereas in case of multitasking, we are using processor time or CPU time in an optimum way. We can use several jobs at a time. And the main disadvantage of your multitasking is it consumes a lot of time. It sits and idle. Here the main advantage is what? We are using processor in an optimum way. At least two differences with 2 points, you can write two differences in the examination, and moreover you'll be getting it for 2 marks or 3 marks. Okay. And this multitasking is of two types: process based multitasking and thread based multitasking. And single tasking, there won't be any category. One task will be there. One task will be executed by the CPU. No one is going with the single tasking. Every processor will do multitasking only. And in process-based multitasking, what happens is there is only one process control, and this process control consists of some set of process P1, P2, P3, P4. And now CPU, certain time of CPU will be given to P1. After that, it goes to P2. Again, it goes to P3. From P3, it goes to P4. After the completion of P4, again, it goes with what? Again, it goes with what? P1. After that, again, it goes like that continuously. That means certain amount of time of CPU will be allocated for each and every process, and CPU is going to provide for each and every process. That means when I'm going to work with Zoom app, along with this Zoom app, the CPU is going to provide service with command to the command prompt also, and Notepad also it's going to provide, but we are not able to observe it. How it is going to provide, we are not able to observe it. It's a fraction of seconds. We are not in a position to observe that duration also, how much time that CPU is spending with this Zoom app, how much time that CPU is spending with the CPU, what command prompt, how much time the CPU is going to spend with Notepad. We are not in a position to imagine that also. We feel that parallelly all these things are running, but parallelly all these things are not running. At a time, CPU is going to provide service to only one processor. Only one processor. But we can't estimate it, because what happens is I'm giving certain input, and that input reaches to CPU. CPU immediately processes it and generates it. And it goes in such a way, it travels again from other set of electronic components and comes to us. Meanwhile, this traveling, the CPU is going to provide services to other process. And if you know, Zoom app then work chestunnara. Zoom app dwara kontha input ichanu. Input CPU daggara kellindi, process chesindi. Immediately ichesin tarvata traveling lo untundi remaining. Ante it comes from CPU to other device, from other device it comes to what? Output device. Meanwhile, CPU is going to provide services to other process, P2, P3, P4. Like that, we are not in a position to observe how the CPU is going to do over there. How the CPU is going to do over there. But we need to imagine that this is how the CPU will be doing. Certain time will be given to P1, certain time will be given to P2, certain time will be given to P3. Like that, the CPU is going to do, right? This is what process-based multitasking. And coming to this thread-based multitasking, in one single process, there might be multiple threads acting on. Then some processor time will be given to T1. Some processor time will be given to T2. Some processor time will be given to what? T3. Again, it goes to T1. This is going to be happened in a single software. Like this, for example, I'm going to start Zoom app. After starting Zoom app only, I'm in a position to click on mic, mute and unmute. Video mute and unmute. Without starting Zoom app, I'm in a position to do that thing. మ్యూట్ అండ్ అన్మ్యూట్ చేయడానికి పాసిబిలిటీ ఉంటుందా?
నో సార్.
ఎందుకు? అక్కడ మెయిన్ థ్రెడ్ అనేది స్టార్ట్ అవ్వాలి, అంటే జూమ్ యాప్ అనేది ఇనిషియల్ గా స్టార్ట్ అవ్వాలి. జూమ్ యాప్ స్టార్ట్ అయిన తర్వాత దేర్ విల్ బి అ సపరేట్ థ్రెడ్ ఫర్ వాట్ ఆడియో అండ్ వీడియో, అండ్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు డూ సర్టెన్ ఆపరేషన్స్, అండ్ దోస్ ఆపరేషన్స్ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు వర్క్ ఓవర్ దేర్. ఓకే, సో పారలలీ దిస్ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ ఆన్ లైక్ ఇన్ జూమ్ యాప్. వాట్ వీ కెన్ కంక్లూడ్ దట్ త్రీ థ్రెడ్స్ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ ఆన్ పారలలీ. One thread is sharing the video, sharing the content. Other thread is video. Other thread is audio. Three things are going on parallelly. Three things are working on three different objects. One is content projection. Other one is webcam thing. Other one is what? Audio. Three different threads are working parallelly. But coming to this mic button and then video, wantedly, if user clicks on that, then it is going to be done. But here what happens is the user can do the diagram on this screen, and he can do some action, and that action you can see, and he can talk, and that also you can see. That means three things parallelly going on in your Zoom app. This is one of the best example to understand about your threads concept. Okay, clear with this process based multi thread based multitasking?
Yes sir.
Right. Uses of threads means mainly it is going to be used in server-side programs. I already discussed in thread synchronization that booking a ticket through BookMyShow or any other app, there will be using this threads concept. Internally, we'll be using over there, but we're not able to know that how we are using, but internally we'll be using over there. And threads are used to create games and animations, that also we know. Okay. And next thing is multi-threading. Refers to two or more tasks executing concurrently within a single program. That means if you consider one single program, and in this single program, what happens is we'll be executing the part parallelly, two different parts or three different parts parallelly we are executing. That is what multi-threading. And this multi-threading can be implemented by using runnable interface and by using what? Thread class. By using runnable interface and by using what? Thread class. If what multi-threading was implemented by using runnable interface means, So this is how we are implementing a program, what thread by using runnable interface. So there will be one method called run method, and we are taking sleep method. We are printing I value. And then when your thread was implementing, when your class was implementing runnable interface, means we need to create an object for that particular class. First of all, after creating an object for that particular class, we need to create a thread object. We need to create thread object. To that thread object, we need to send this object. This is only the case where your class is going to be implemented by runnable interface. If your class is implementing runnable interface, means this is how we'll be creating a thread. If your class is extending a thread class, means no need to create this. Directly you can take what t.start. Directly you can take what t.start. Okay. t.start. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If your class is implementing runnable interface, means then we need to create an object for that particular class, and this object we need to pass it to what? Thread class. Then only your tdemo1 will get a capability of what? Executing threads. Otherwise it doesn't have a capability to having to getting what? Threads. Okay, t.start start method was called start internally creates a thread, and that what a thread is going to execute what? Run method. The thread is going to execute what? Run method. This is how the basic thing, how a thread is going to be created by using what? Runnable interface. Now I'm going with one more program. I'm going to open one more program, notepad tdemo, right? So here this tdemo extends thread class. In this case, same logic is there. In this case, what happens is I'm creating an object for this tdemo, because tdemo was extending thread class, and directly I'm going to call t.start. Start internally creates thread, and it calls what? Run method. You observe the difference between these two programs. You can observe the difference between this two programs. What was happened? This is by using runnable interface. We created an object of class, and that object we are passing it to thread class. And here what we have done, we creating an object for thread class, and we are going to call t.d.start. Okay, clear?
Yes.
Right. Try to keep this in your brain, students. If class implements runnable, create an object for that class and send that object to thread class, then only we are in a position to create thread. If the class is extending thread class, means directly you create an object and then call start method. Call start method. Okay. So this is how a thread is going to be created by using runnable interface. Now, this is what the thing. Now, sleep method. Sleep means what? It's a static method. So we need to call with respect to class name thread.sleep. And within parentheses, we'll be giving some integer value and or some long value. And that value milliseconds, this thread is going to sleep. Thread is going to sleep. Thread sleeping means it stops execution for those milliseconds, and if those milliseconds was expired, means again it comes out of the sleep mode. So this is what happened over there. Next, single tasking in the sense, suppose I would like to perform one task. So that what I'm doing is I'm taking one object, and on that object I'm taking run method, and run method I'm going to take. On this object I'm making thread to start, and from that run method again I'm going to call different methods, that is task one method. And then after that, I'm going with task two method. After that, I'm going with what? A task three method. So this is how single tasking is going to be done. See what happens in single tasking is, right? So one simple thing, that I created an object, very simple thing here. I created an object over here, single tasking, st is equal to new single tasking, st dot start. So single tasking, first of all, see the single tasking extends what? Thread class. So that's the reason I'm creating an object directly, and I'm going to call what? st.start. If I call st.start, means start internally creates a thread, and it calls a method called what? Run method. So inside this run method, I'm going to call task one function. It goes, executes it, come back. Again, task two function goes, executes it, and come back. Task three method goes, executes it, and comes back. So this is one simple thing. If you want to perform some task, then we can call a particular function from run method. This is what single tasking, very simple thing, just like creating a thread. Now, one more thing is there, multitasking. So in multitasking, what we are doing is, we are creating multiple objects. In multitasking, this multitasking extends thread. So what I'm doing is I'm creating two objects over here. One is D object, other one is D1 objects. Two different objects I'm creating in multitasking. In multitasking, what I've done is I created D object, and D object contains run method, and I created D1 object, and this D1 object contains what? Run method. Run method. In both cases, we have what? Run method. Run method. Now on these two objects, what I'm doing is I'm making initiating one thread. Let us assume that this is thread T1 and this is what? Thread T2. This is what? Thread T2. I'm initiating two different threads on this. One is T1. I will make T1 to enter into this D object and T2 to enter into what? D2 object. Parallelly, two different things are going to be executed. Two different things will be executed and main method is going to be executed. This is what multitasking using threads. Now, after having one doubt that first phase, what I done is I created an object students. And on this object, I created one thread. I'm making one thread to start. Okay, T and a thread now, T, D and a thread now, they have a thread in start JSON, thread and a parallel execution JSON. Next time in JSON, two different objects in create JSON, two threads in initiate JSON, two different objects in create JSON, two different objects in create JSON, and two threads in initiate JSON, T, T1 and a thread in initiate JSON, T, T1 are going to execute what your runnable run method, right? So now the next thing, what I'm going to have thing is, I will be creating one object students and I will be initiating two different threads over here. I will be initiating two different threads over there. That means okate run method undi, okate object okate run method undi, but our run method meda two threads ni invoke chestunnam. Chesinappudu em avutundi, I will be getting a problem over there. In order to resolve that problem, we are going with a concept called thread synchronization. We are going with a concept called what? A thread synchronization. Multiple threads acting on one single object. That means there is only one object I have taken. On this object, there will be a method called run method. And on this run method, we are making two threads to run. In this case, what happens is we'll be getting some unreliable output. In this case, we'll be getting what? Some unreliable output. In order to do that, we are going with a concept called thread synchronization. And the purpose of that thread synchronization is one thread is entered into what a run method means. It doesn't allow another thread to enter into that run method. It stops here itself. Until execution of this thread was completed, then only it allows another thread to enter into that run method. Up to that, doesn't allows any other thread to enter into it. Okay, so in order to do that, we are going with a concept called thread synchronization. Thread synchronization is recommended when multiple threads are used on the same object. Multiple threads are used on a same object. Doesn't allows one thread is acting on an object, it doesn't allows any other thread to act on it. It doesn't allows any other thread to act on it. So this is what thread synchronization, and this thread synchronization can be done or can be achieved in Java with the help of synchronized keyword. Synchronized is one keyword which can be used with respect to variables and methods. If a method is contains a synchronized keyword, then if any one thread entered into that method, it doesn't allows any other thread to enter. Until and unless execution of thread is going to be completed, which was entered earlier. If a block is taken as synchronized, then no other threads will be entered into that particular block until and unless current thread execution was completed. So this is how we are done synchronized OBJ, and it doesn't allow other statements. Synchronized before method name will be taking what? Synchronized over there. Now, if you go with the program, so here, if I'm not going to take synchronized for this program and I'm going to compile this java.multiobject.java, Java C space multiobject.java and Java space -cp. So main method, dear second person available birthar one, first dear first person available birthar one. For two threads, it's showing what available birth one and one. One birth is reserved for two first person and then second person. This is not an efficient output. So what happened is here two threads was entered parallelly into this run method. That's the reason we got unreliable output. So in order to do that, what we'll be doing is we'll be taking synchronized keyword over here. Synchronized keyword over here. Now I'm going to compile it, Java C multiobject.java, and I'm going to run it. So dear first person, available births are one. Available birth, one birth reserved for second person. After completion of this first thread, and then only second thread message I got over here. second thread message I got over here. This is what thread synchronization. This is what a thread synchronization. Next, thread lifecycle or Java thread model, both are same. Thread lifecycle or Java thread model, both are same. Now, what happens in this thread lifecycle and Java thread model is that first of all, we'll be creating a thread, and after creating a thread, it goes with start, and from start, it goes with ready or runnable. If we call start method, then it comes to ready or runnable, and start automatically calls run method, it goes to running state. If from running state, if sleep method was called means, then it goes to the sleeping. Again, it comes to after expiry, it comes to ready or runnable, and then it moves to running state. If wait is called means it's going to be in waiting state. And when thread will come out from waiting state means if you call a notify function, then only it comes out of the waiting state to ready or runnable state. If all executions has been completed, it comes to what? A dead state. It comes to what? Dead state. So this is what thread lifecycle. And then thread priorities we'll be discussing, and inter-thread communication. Last class itself, we discussed clearly about this. And if they want to exchange some data, then this threads concept is going to produce. We are going with inter-thread communication. And we came up with an example that producer-consumer problem. And we have seen a program of producer-consumer problem, how consumer will take producer object, and with the help of that object, it is checking data production over variable. And that is true, then only it allows you to take the data. So that we discussed in the last classes itself. Okay, so inter-thread communication, if possible, I will revise it in the next class. There is fourth hour class. And then thread priorities are there and thread class is there. These two topics are there in unit 3. I will discuss in the next class, and then I'll go with the object class in the next class. Okay. So see, students, I felt very bad. Very bad, because this many hours I spent, this many classes I'm taking for you, but you're not showing an interest on this. Okay. At least watch the videos which was placed on the YouTube. For your purpose only, I made it as a public. Everyone can see it at any time. Okay. So try to look into it and then do it. Okay. Revise the things. If you have any doubts, I'm there with you. I will be helping with you, right? Any doubts, students?
No, sir.
Yeah, just a revision I would like to do in multi-threading that I had done. What's the next class? Next class timing? Already they given link. Okay. Okay, students, you can leave. And I will be sharing the link again for the fourth hour, and then we'll close off this unit 3. Maniteja, you're saying something, I'm not able to listen to you.